Still in the news, pressure is mounting residents and leaders of Akwach sub-county in Gulu district after National Forestry Authority marked stones were mysteriously dug into the middle of the road. The area LC5 councillor Kenneth Odong Oyet says they were not consulted when the marked stones were planted between 7th and 10th of July. They claim the stone marks were hindering transport on a 94-year-old road, which gives access to Health Center 4, the district headquarters, and missionary schools.
Standing while leaning on the 2.5-meter-high marked stones, the Awaj sub-county LC5 councillor Oyet Kenneth Odong says they have been surprised that the road was blocked.
And not only garden, what about health services? If our people are going to town, where will they cross from? If at all there's any service delivery from the city, where will they cross from? If at all there's any like referral from the health center force, where will they cross from? I don't know what they are doing. Are they prioritizing forest than human beings?
And the authorities were not consulted when the National Forestry Authority marked stones were dug on the road.
Found that they have totally now blocked the road. And information concerning this is not clear because when they were putting, they didn't consult community members, even local councillors, 1, 2, 3, and sub-county chief, including the district authorities, like the office of the LC5, COW, and even the RDC.
The road connects Gulu City to Gulu District headquarters at Awaj Town Council. Okello O'Brien, a border rider, is calling on the National Forestry Authority to remove the marked stones as carrying large commodities has become impossible.
The only road that can connect Awaj Town, Gulu Town to Gulu City. So when it is blocked, we may not be easily transported. Our good sense, we have a business in these trading centers.
And this could demoralize residents from seeking health services from Awaj Health Center 4. Speaking in the Luo dialect of Acholi, the area LOC1 chairperson Komakechi Santu reveals that efforts to organize a meeting with the NFA management in the Achua River Range were futile as they failed to reply to his request.
This is their land. They should leave the road for the people to pass. Mm-hmm. While they can use the other side or that other side, while the road is safe for people to move in. We have many institutions in Awaj Health Center, like Awaj Health Center 4. There are many schools in Awaj Health Center 4 in Awaj. So it will be very difficult for them to get through to Awaj Health Center, as there's no alternative route apart from this.
However, with the pressure mounting, the National Forestry Authority range manager in Lango and Acholi sub-regions, Jimmy Owona, says the marked stones were placed to stop people from encroaching into the Amoka Forest Reserve.
Forests are like any other forests within the region, suffer degradation, suffer the encroachment, and suffer the legal integrity, because we have to show the boundary of the forest to people, and we have not done it for quite some time. So the court ordered that we saw the boundary, and we went and opened the boundary. I have had calls from many people, journalists, district leaders, that even the LC5 came to me, was complaining of the way the marked stone was put. But I told them that the marked stone is to show where the forest boundary is.
He explains that the marked stones are temporary and will be removed.
We wanted to people to get used to where the boundary passes, and we are going to remove it. Those ones which are close to the road, because definitely even what I saw, it can cause accident. So we told them we are going to remove after people knowing where the boundary is. But with time, we are going to remove and leave only those ones which are there.
Reporting for the news, I am Joseph Omagor in Gulu City.